biggest projects in Cleveland history, but tonight there are questions about the man in charge.
The Museum of Art is in the midst of a $250 million expansion that has shut down the museum for 6 months.
Channel 3's Vic Gideon reports that the head architect has been sued for similar projects in other cities for not paying enough attention to detail.
Well, this really shows the grand vision that Vignoli had when he took on this project.
The grand vision of Raphael Vignoli will marry the original 1916 Museum of Art building with a 1971 addition designed by Marcel Breuer.
It's just brilliant. It's just quite brilliant.
That brilliant design replaces two other additions, but increases gallery space by almost 40%. It also improves the museum experience for visitors. It's meant to be a state-of-the-art architectural masterpiece, meant to elicit a response in the beholder.
Wow.
But after the museum hired Vignoli to execute its great vision, the architect has been sued on two other projects, the Kimmel Center for the Performing Arts, home to the Philadelphia Orchestra, and the $850 million Boston Convention and Exhibition Center. Both are grand and majestic, but are flawed steel and glass structures. The Kimmel suit has been settled, but the complaint calls Vignoli an architect who had a grand vision but was unable to convert that vision into reality. The project ran $23 million over budget. In Boston, the Convention Center's suit seeks to recover millions of dollars of damages that it has incurred as a result of errors, omissions, and deficiencies in the design services, particularly with the roof, which leaked. The architect, Uruguay-born and New York-based Raphael Vignoli, through his firm wrote, "None of this has any bearing on the Cleveland Museum of Art whatsoever." However, a glass roof over a piazza, bridging two existing buildings, is the centerpiece of Vignoli's Cleveland design.
He assured us, you know, nothing that happened there would affect our project because of the way we've been running it, so we're very comfortable.
The museum's been closed since January, but despite Vignoli's rush to get the Philadelphia project done on time, the Cleveland Museum of Art says construction is on schedule here, and they're confident that the building will reopen as planned in the fall.
At this point, I'm at the end of March. We're planning open. We will open.
Open on time and on budget, according to Ash, because the museum has the right experienced team in place to execute Vignoli's vision. The museum says it's done thorough testing throughout the process to avoid Cleveland being lawsuit number three.
We are doing everything that I think is possible by the museum to make sure we are not.
Well, this project is not only important but massive, with construction lasting a total of 6 years. The museum will open in phases, with summer in the courtyard beginning in mid-July and a Barcelona exhibit opening on time October 15th in an existing addition featuring the works of Dali and Picasso. The museum in the interim has opened a store on Shaker Square. Ramona, Tim, back to you.
Vic, why does the architect say these lawsuits don't apply to Cleveland?
Well, according to the museum, they say that the Vignoli design was not the problem, but it was the execution of that design. They say they have taken the proper measures to make sure that the right people are in charge of the construction to make sure that this complicated and complex vision is realized.
We'll keep a close eye on it. The whole community will.